everyone. I'm Heather Poduska, star maker for entrepreneurs who want to unlock their potential, command any stage, and make blockbuster profits. Welcome to Thrive, the show where I bring you tips, resources, and people to help you create a brand that makes you happy and profitable. Here we go.
Hi, everyone. I'm Heather Poduska, and welcome to this episode of Thrive, How to Create a Happy and Healthy Life, with my guest, Jen Karofsky. Jen Karofsky is a holistic life and health coach with over 25 years of coaching experience coaching women, men, and families to create a healthy and happy life. On this episode, Jen shares with us powerful strategies that we can use to boost our creativity and our energy. And for people like me and like other entrepreneurs who are sitting behind a desk and behind a computer all day, Jen shares with us some simple strategies that we can use to keep us healthy while we're working. And finally, Jen talks to us about why it's so important to honor our own voice so that we can start to make choices that are customized to our individual needs. Jen is a real sweetheart, and she shares great content. I hope you enjoy the show. Hi, everyone. I'm Heather Poduska, and welcome to Thrive, the show where I bring you tips, resources, and people to help you create a brand that makes you happy and profitable. You're in for 30 minutes of content coming to you from industry leaders who are growing their businesses, making an impact, and rocking their brands. And I am thrilled to have my guest here with me today, Jen Karofsky. Jen has over 25 years of professional experience coaching women, men, and families. With intuition, gentle wisdom, and manageable strategies, Jen helps her clients become more empowered to make changes in order to live healthier, happier lives. She holds a master's degree in counseling psychology, is a board-certified integrative holistic health coach, and is Reiki-trained. When she's not supporting her clients, she can be found boxing, hiking, cooking, and spending time with her husband, two children, and her loving golden retriever. Does the golden retriever have a name?
Bodhi. I'm sure he will show up eventually for this.
So a shout out to Brody. Is it Brody? Is that right?
Bodhi.
Oh, okay. Sorry, Bodhi. Awesome. Welcome. I'm so happy to have you here.
Thanks for having me. I'm so excited.
So I read that, you know, the official introduction, but talk to us a little bit about what you do with clients. What is the work that you are doing as someone who is Reiki certified, is helping people live healthier, happy lives? What does that look like?
That's a great question. I am very passionate about helping people who are very stressed and overwhelmed and feel really dissatisfied in their lives get a clear vision on their life values and the goals they want. And together we create a life plan that really aligns with those values and the life they truly desire. Primarily the women and men that I work with are in their late 30s, 40s, and 50s. So they're at an interesting phase in their life where when they're young, they're go-getters or they're having babies or they're building a career. And sometimes when we get to this point in our lives, we kind of look around and say, huh, is this what I want? It might have been what you wanted when you were younger, but things change and we change and we grow and people get to a point. Some people get to a point where they feel like they're in a transition. They're not very happy and they don't really know what to do. So those are my clients. We sit down, we tweak things out. We get clear on who they are at this point in their lives, not who they were when they were 20. And then we create a real plan together that works so that they can be happy and healthy and do the things that really fuel them moving forward.
That's awesome. That's awesome. So just one little comment in the chat. Can you hear, is there an echo when I'm speaking?
No.
Okay, cool. Oh, cool. Great. Thank you for letting me know, Carrie. So one of the questions that I have is, you mentioned your clients are a little bit older or depending on your perspective, a little bit younger,
yeah.
Right?
Let's be kind.
Where do you find that most people get stuck? Is there a pattern for your clients where they get stuck in their lives at that point in their lives when they've been around the sun a few times, as I like to say?
I think that, you know, my male clients and my female clients are a little bit different. So let me speak to the women. We if we, especially if we are having children and we're working, whether as a full-time mom or working out of the home on our own business or going to work every day, we are giving, giving, giving all the time. And when you are raising children or taking care of a home or working a business and helping others, depending on how you serve, you usually come last. So you don't take that time. You feel guilty for taking that time. And at a certain point, that catches up with you. And so I find that it's not that that voice wasn't there all along saying, oh, maybe you should eat this way, or maybe you should find a new place to work out, or maybe you're not really satisfied with your social group. But we push down that voice quite often because it takes a lot of energy to self-care. And as caregivers, again, we're not very good at it. So eventually that voice gets louder and louder, and you can choose to listen to it, or you can choose to continue down a path that's not very satisfying. And my clients are really at the point where they want to take action. They're not the people laying in bed all day. They're getting up. They are going to work. They're taking care of their kids. They're making dinner. But they feel like they're juggling so much that something is going to fall apart eventually. That's the point they're at.
So do you help people understand, or I should say it differently, do you help people with strategies to tune into that voice before it gets to the point of being a crisis, or before they are really stressed and maybe their health is deteriorating? Is that one of the things that you help people do, to say, oh, my body is speaking to me, or my heart is speaking to me?
Yeah. You know, we're living in a really amazing time. Not only are alternative therapies, so to speak, or personal development courses really out there all over the place, but we have access to them. And long ago, people really didn't know what to do. And they had a community of neighbors and a social group that was really supportive. But we are scattered all over the place right now. And so there's tons of information that we can get. You can go online and research anything. I mean, if I went online and put in a symptom, who knows what would show up? I feel like people really have access to the information, but they don't know what to do with it. They don't have someone in their corner helping them get through all the information, figuring out which information really speaks to them authentically. So my work is not to tell you what to do. It's to help you navigate everything that's out there, because I truly believe that deep down inside, we know what we should be doing, but we're not doing it. We know if there's a relationship in our lives that's not fueling us, but we don't really know how to communicate our way out of it or to a different space in it. We know when things feel hectic or our marriage is disconnected. We know, but taking the time to focus in and figure out what to do is really so beneficial and so powerful. And when people work with me, that they're making a commitment to themselves and they're creating the space to do that.
Yeah. And don't you find, I find that as well with my clients, that is a huge part of the gift of hiring someone in whatever it is, if it's a tennis coach or a health coach or a business coach, is to create that time and that space to be with yourself, to hear yourself, to get feedback. And I think you're right. People charge ahead. And when you're an entrepreneur and you're a mom and you're a dad or whatever that role is that you're playing, we all wear different hats. Mm-hmm. It's hard to take that space and that time. Right. But what would you say to someone who says, I can't, or I don't know how to prioritize? How would you help them with that?
In terms of working with a coach or in terms of life?
Getting their act together so that they could be happier. Because I know for myself, I have kids, I have a husband, I have a home, I have extended family, I have my business that I love, I'm a singer, mm-hmm. and I'm passionate about all of those things. And I don't want to give them up. I want to live a 10X life. I want all of it, but all of it,
you know, some, it's a lot. So how do you, how would you talk to people about prioritizing that and still staying, you know, energized with their goals?
So I think that some people can do 10 things at once for a period of time. Mm-hmm. But I think the messaging that we need to do it all and have it all is hurting us. I think we can do it all and have it all, but we might not be able to do it all and have it all at exactly the same time. Mm-hmm. And so when you wake up every morning and you're like, oh my God, I have to do this again, something is telling you that this is not working. Or wake up and you're feeling bloated, or you're snapping at your children, or you're feeling like you're not connecting with the people in your life that are truly, truly important to you. That's a message, and you can choose to listen to it or not. It is a choice. You have a choice in your life. You have the power to live the life you want, the way you want to live it. So it's really mindset. It's really thinking about and changing how you do things and working towards what you want.
So I think some people actually don't feel like they have a choice.
Some people don't feel like they have a choice.
But they do have a choice.
I believe you have a choice. I believe even if you can't change your circumstances, you can change how you think about them. So, you know, it's really great to say, oh, you know, leave your job if you're not happy, or, you know, eat organic if that's what you're passionate about. But if finances are tough, if you have financial commitments, which we all do, if you can't move to the place that you desire, you can still feel good about your life. You can still make choices along the way that make you feel more powerful, where you use your voice in a way that is authentic. You wake up saying, instead of looking in the mirror and saying, oh God, you know, my thighs are so fat, you could say, oh my God, my eyes are so beautiful. So it sounds,
I'm going to remember that.
It sounds a little cheesy maybe, but it really is making, and it can be very small things like that, where you just tweak things and you, it lightens you a little bit and you go, oh my gosh, if I can do this, then maybe I can start looking for another job. Maybe I can find a way to communicate differently with my teenager who's shutting the door every day, or my husband who I haven't gone out with in, you know, 6 months. It's really within you to make those changes, but it can be hard, and that's where I come in.
Right. So say I do want to make a change, and I'm not sure what that change is, and I come to you. How would we go about looking at that? What would be the cues to say this is a yes, this is a maybe not?
That's a great question. So what I would do originally is have a brief phone call with someone who's interested in working with a coach, and just see if we're a good fit. First of all, I have a huge network of people that are extremely talented, and I want to make sure that we're the right fit, because this is an investment in your time and in your money, and you deserve to have exactly the right person for you. So making sure we're a good personality fit. I use a lot of humor in my work. I don't know if that's coming through right now, but so people who don't laugh a lot might not want to work with me. So then I have someone fill out a pretty extensive questionnaire where I ask really what you're focusing on. And it helps trigger some thoughts for you. It makes you think about maybe in the area of relationships, I'm actually doing really well. But in health, that's not so good. And I start up every Monday. Every Monday I say I'm going to eat well. But by, you know, Tuesday night, it's not working. Where are the issues for you? We spend about 90 minutes, maybe 2 hours together. And then we design together a plan that has you on the track towards the things that you want.
Okay, cool. So I'm trying to understand what this question is. We have someone who has a question. So when you say to make a change, can you change a goal or focus, or does that have to be there? And also, what is a good goal, a good for healthy if you are at the desk? So I didn't quite get that, but I think, can you change your goals? And the question also is, I think this is a great one because we work at our desks a lot. What are some healthy things that we can do to boost our energy, our creativity, if we're at a desk job all day or an entrepreneur who's behind the computer 6 hours a day?
That's a great question. Let me start with the first part, changing your goals. I absolutely believe you can change your goals because I think that sometimes goals are not exactly the right fit, especially when you're first starting out setting goals, and they might not really align with you. And that's the work we'll do together. Does that really make sense? Is that something, you know, I want to, I don't know, you know, I want to spend, you know, every Saturday with my teenage son. Well, if your teenage son is not even talking to you, maybe that's not the first step in working towards that goal. Maybe it's really understanding your kid. Maybe it's starting with baby steps. So I think that goals can change. I get that. I have goal cards that I use. And one time I wrote it down and I said to my coach, I was like, what if it doesn't happen? You know, am I failing? And she was great. She's like, no, it just might not have been realistic at this time in your life. And it took a lot of the pressure off.
Yeah, and I always think, and I teach that I think you should make goals that make you feel really excited. I mean, what's the point of making a goal that's kind of halfway? Because you're not going to be as energized to go for that goal. And when you get there, you're still only halfway anyway. So if you set a goal that's really like a big goal that makes you super excited, even if you miss, you're probably going to get further along than you would have if you had set sort of like a halfway, like lukewarm goal. You can always change your goals, but I always think shoot for the moon. And if you fall like, you know, 3/4 of the way there, you're still way, way ahead of the game.
Absolutely. And shoot, you know, goals are nothing unless you have a plan to go along with them. They're just wishes. Yeah. You know, it's nice to have wishes and it's all nice and pretty. But I'm really action focused. And so you might have a goal, but we need to come up with a plan to support that goal. It's just like if you go to the gym and you're like, you know, I want to do a Spartan race. Well, how are you going to get to being, you know, making it through a Spartan race the way you want to make it through? It is having a plan that's manageable, that's not too overwhelming, although some people are challenged by that, but most of my clients are not because it's scary to make changes sometimes. But the power you feel once you do is incredible. And it makes you realize that you can do anything, and you can also teach your kids to do anything.
That's right. So what about the second part of it? That what are some simple things that we can do to improve our health if we are at a desk job or sitting for long periods of time, or even like if you have to fly for work and you're on a flight and, you know, what can you do when you're...
I get that a lot. I get that question a lot. One of the number one things that you should be doing all day is drinking a lot of water.
I remember you told me that a while back, and I have a glass that I sit next to my sink. Good. And every time I walk by, if it's empty, I fill it. And
yeah. Most people are pretty dehydrated, and when we're dehydrated, it can make us feel hungry and it can make us feel fatigued and we're not as clear, especially when we're working so hard. So I would say up your water. There's probably no one out there on the call who is drinking enough water. And I too struggle with that. I would say get up and move. We sit all day long and we don't ever have to get up, but you do. You need to move, you need to stretch, you need to tweak that in your day, fit it in different places.
Yeah, some people I know set timers either on their, you know, their phone or their watch. So every hour it dings, you know, get up, walk 5 minutes, sit back down.
Right. Stick a post-it note on your computer, write it on your hand if you have to right now. I mean, you have to create habits. This is, you can't change without creating new habits. Developing a habit takes some time. It really does. And I think we're such a fast-paced society and we are looking for quick fixes. And you can't drink water one day and then say, oh, okay, I did it. But you're trying to create a new lifestyle here. And so sitting at a desk, planning around food, it's very easy to eat poorly when either you're sitting at a desk at home or you're in an office or you're on the road, because the food that you can grab is usually pretty bad. Processed.
So what would give us like three awesome foods to have at your desk?
Nuts, fruit, cut up vegetables.
And cut up vegetables. So that does take a little bit of planning, because if you're going to bring cut up veg, or, you know, actually you can go to Whole Foods or grocery stores and they have those little sections where the veggies are already cut up for you.
Yep. You can absolutely go to Whole Foods and in the morning or at the beginning of the week, you know, have a whole bunch of food cut up ready to go. But I think that keeping your energy level up so you don't go and grab a donut or a muffin or something like that, because all that's going to do is give you a sugar buzz and then you're going to crash again and you're going to go for more. So really sustained energy throughout the day, having a really good breakfast. I know moms always said breakfast is a really important meal of the day. I find that to be true, that you do need to eat. You are breaking fast from the night before.
So what do you say to those people who are, you know, like my husband, he doesn't eat breakfast. I don't think he's eaten breakfast in 20 years, you know, but he has his coffee every. What would you say to those people? Like if you're saying do eat breakfast, what would be a way to ease into it if you're just a coffee drinker?
You know, some people go through their day and they're really happy that way. So if he's happy that way, that is his choice, right? I mean, that is how he wants to go through his day. I have many clients who start out, I drink coffee in the morning and then I drink another one at lunch and then I drink another one in the afternoon. But then I gorge myself at dinner and then I go to bed and I feel really bloated and pretty crap.
Yeah.
So that is your choice. But if you want different, you have to do different.
If you want, that's a tweetable, people. If you want different, you have to do different. So what would be a simple, for people who are, you know, phobic about breakfast, what would be a simple, delicious little thing that they could start with?
I like meals, but I understand that life is very busy. So quite often my clients, we do smoothies in the morning because it's fast and easy. And I get it. You're getting the kids one place, you're going another place, you know, you got to let the dog out. It's crazy. So really healthy smoothies that are full of vegetables and fruit is a great thing to get in you. I'd rather you get something in you than nothing in you. But hard-boiled eggs, you can grab an egg and a piece of fruit. If you have time, you can make a nice breakfast. But honor that time for yourself, because it really will make a difference in your day.
I think that's really key, what you just said, to honor that time in the morning. And I'm a really, really big believer and practicer of morning rituals. I have a very specific ritual in the morning. And I know everybody has different ones, but mine is I get up, I tidy the house a little bit, I meditate for 10 to 15 minutes, and then I hit the gym. Mm-hmm. And so that's sort of mine. And then I come home and I have a smoothie. And my smoothie is spinach, avocado, some kind of a fruit and a protein powder, and that's my smoothie. And so what would you say are some good morning rituals, not just for eating, but, you know, I know that you're all about holistic life, holistic health, holistic happiness, and you're saying take that time, honor yourself. Yes. And I really like what you're saying about that. It's not just how can I shove something in my mouth and get out the door as fast as possible.
Right.
So talk to us a little bit about that, about honoring yourself, honoring the space, and creating rituals around that.
Well, I'm sure it took you some time to create that morning ritual, right?
Yeah. And I tweak it too. It's not always, you know.
Right. So if I'm speaking to busy working people, that might mean making some changes, like getting up 10 minutes earlier. Some people are like, I could never do that. I could never get up.
Well, you know what I say? You know what I say to people when they say that? Because I know a lot of people like too. It's like, is that 10 minutes of sleep going to make a difference in your restedness?
I know.
No.
Right. And that brings you back to the night before. Are you going to sleep on time? I mean, really, you can't just look at one piece here. You have to look at kind of the whole piece. It's almost like when I tell people who are working with kids, I'm like, don't look at their daily food intakes. Let's look at their week. What does their week look like? Because days are different and it's flowy and they're, you know, you could have the best intention to get up and meditate in the morning, but your kid woke up in the middle of the night and they're sick. So it's not going to happen. Give yourself a break. But if you're constantly being mindful about it and thinking about what you should do, eventually you're going to find a flow that works for your life and your health. And I think that's really, we put a lot of pressure on ourselves to, you know, we read an article and like, holy shit, I got to do that. That's what I have to do. Give yourself a break. It is hard. Life is busy. But if you set the intention and work towards it, you will get there. You will find what fits for you.
So can you give us some strategies then to inoculate ourselves from these stressors? You know, we have teenage kids that are lovely and drive us crazy, and we have work and deadlines, and really, you talked about relationships that, you know, you may be evolving, but maybe the people around you aren't evolving. How do you inoculate yourself and protect yourself and really keep that bubble of health and happiness going? So what would be some ways to protect yourself from that?
I think it's not so much protecting yourself. It's more like seeing it happening. Maybe it is protecting yourself, but it doesn't get you in your gut. It doesn't get you in your core. So for me, I went through a period of time where I knew I was not happy. And I was like, oh my God, what do I do here? I didn't know either. It was a weird place to be because I was feeling disconnected and tired and overwhelmed. I'm like, how in the world could I even focus on myself? Because the world will fall apart if I take time away. But the fact was, the world was kind of, not the world, but things were too chaotic, and they were going to be whether I took care of myself or not. Mm-hmm. And I knew that if I did, I could make things a little better around. So it's really finding the time, finding what resonates with you. If it's working with a coach, if it's trying a new eating plan, if it's finding, taking, you know, 10 minutes a day to meditate, go outside, take a walk, connect with people that fuel you, not people mm-hmm. that drain you. Go ahead.
I was going to say, one of the things that I talk to people about and that I do personally is that, you know, we have some people in our lives that we have to be around, that they are part of our sphere. And sometimes it can negatively impact it's toxic.
Yeah.
They might even be people that you love, but it does impact your mindset and your psyche. And I always think about taking like a psychic shower afterwards, after I'm with them, just to rinse that energy off. And I read some research that said your brain is designed to keep you safe. So it gloms on to negativity much more quickly than positive things, because that's its job, to keep you safe. And you can speak to this because you have the psychology background, but that you need three positive encounters, three positive pieces of information to counterbalance one negative one. So I always try to say, okay, if something negative happened to me, what three positive things can I do now to reset the balance back?
Right. And I think that's great. Taking a shower, if that makes you feel good, if that's what works, you know, wearing a piece of jewelry that makes you feel really powerful when you're in a situation. I truly believe that it is very healthy to create boundaries if something is not working for us. There are a lot of shoulds that we live by. I should go to that family dinner. I should go out to dinner with this other couple. I should be on the PTA. But if you're walking out of situations and you are like, oh my gosh, I barely made it through, that's telling you something. So it doesn't necessarily mean that you can't ever have Thanksgiving with your family again. But finding a way to do that might mean you have to take a step back and create some different boundaries for yourself.
So what would that look like? So let's take an example of that. How would you advise somebody that had that exact situation that, you know, they have maybe some difficulty with their family or maybe a work situation, and they know they have to enter that situation? How would you help them navigate that?
A lot of times when people come to me and they're struggling with something like that, the first thing out of their mind is, I can't do that. Hmm. And my belief is you can do whatever you want to do.
Amen.
Right? Hello. You might choose not to do it. But first, we take a big step back and even look at the language we're using. Because we're not victims here. We are making choices to be in those situations that are not fueling us. So personally, I have been in situations where I don't really feel good. I feel like I'm on edge. I feel like I'm using a tremendous amount of energy to be in a certain space, whether it's energetically in the space at a party or with a group of friends or with certain family members. And I, it takes from me over and over again. And what I was finding is if you can't get that back, if you can't get yourself grounded and centered using modalities that you might feel comfortable with, whether it's meditation or going a Reiki or going for a run, then it's really starting to impact you in your core. So saying no is okay. No, I can't be on that committee, but thank you for asking. No, I'm not going to go out to dinner with everybody this time. No, I don't think we can go on that family trip this year. Mm-hmm. There might be consequences. People might not understand. You might have to explain if you so choose to. But if you give constantly, what's left?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, absolutely. So what if somebody is living authentically and they are tuning in? I love what you're saying, Jen, about the signals that are there, that you don't feel right in your body. The energy doesn't feel right. You're feeling inside a no, but trying to like push through something that doesn't feel natural. Or you wake, my favorite thing that you said is you wake up and you're like, I don't think I can get through this again.
Yeah,
I love that because those are real cues. And when, you know, instead of just saying, oh, I've got to, I have to, well, this is my life. Right. I have to do this.
You don't have to.
Right. And you're not a victim. I love that. So say we want to make that change. What can it look like?
That's a great question. I think that, first of all, there's a difference between compromising, right? Like, I'll go back to like going out with another, let's say you and your husband have plans to go out with a couple, another couple, right? And you don't really want to go to that restaurant, but you're like, I'll go to the restaurant. That's a compromise. If going out with this other couple, you're like gripping the chair the whole time, or you're, you know, just going, I have nothing to say, or this is not, you know, I can't even get a word in edgewise. I have such limited time. Why am I spending time in this situation? That is the moment where you have to kind of say, I might need to start saying no. Finding your voice in those situations, it takes time and it takes practice. There's ways to do it that is very rough, and you create real ripple effect that might, like I said, have consequences. There's ways to do it in a way that might be softer. But again, I work with you to find what's most authentic for you. I can't say that. I know people who have completely cut off family members because they got to the point where they're like, that's all they could do. That's really all they could do. And then I have other clients who have done it in different ways that's a little more subtle. You know, maybe I don't have people come to my house for dinner, we can meet out for dinner because when they're in my space, this is too hard. Mm-hmm. But it's really looking at those examples, and you really then go back into how do you feel in certain situations? And taking the time to really look deep within. Again, it's a process and it cannot happen overnight. And that is why my work is not, you know, we don't meet for one session. We really have to meet for a good 4 to 6 months to kind of start working through and navigating the things that you want in your life.
And then what does that look like on the other side? Say you've worked for a few months and someone's starting to see that their life is changing. What are some of the ways, the wonderful ways that people's lives start to change?
I think people get rediscover who they are and what they're passionate about. People become happier and I'm going to use the word lighter, but they don't feel so burdened every day. There's more joy. I think there's more calm within their homes. Their job might be different. Their friends might be different. Or maybe that's not an option to walk away from those things or change that path. But really, truly feeling grounded and authentic and clear. And when you're doing all those things, you're healthier, because you're not feeling so stressed. So if it's in regard to food and weight and energy, all of this comes into alignment because you're working on your whole self. And then you can move forward from a place of power rather than from a place of desperation and fear.
I love what you just said because, yeah, I loved that because as someone who works with business owners and entrepreneurs, one of the things I work with people so often who are so talented. Mm. They are so smart and so gifted at what they do. And the only thing that they need is an injection of confidence in their voice. Yes. That, and that when you turn that power switch on, then it's just, it's like taking one of the, you know, those little blocks that you put under your tire so your car doesn't roll. When you do that, it's like taking that away and then things just start to roll. Mm. And you can do that through business coaching, but you can also do that. And I know this has been true for me is when I am rocking it out on the gym and I feel great and I've had my, I've had a salmon salad for lunch or something like that. I feel more powerful in
and
my business.
Some of the ways I try to have people think about it is, remember when you were a little kid and you just ran around the neighborhood or you skipped through the supermarket and you really didn't give a crap about what other people thought? You know, that's a really powerful place. You weren't thinking so much about what other people would do. You weren't going, oh my God, you know, that magazine said I need to eat this way. You were listening to your body. You slept when you were tired. You ate when you were hungry. You played with who was fun. And you did the things you enjoyed. And I get it. Life happens. But you can still, within all the crazy, find your place that is really authentic to you. And it is, when we get to a certain point in our lives, we have a little bit more time to think about that.
Hi everyone, I hope you're enjoying the show. There's still more great content to come, but I wanted to take just a minute to talk to you about a new course I've created called Close Any Room. You may have noticed that all of my guests know how to speak about their businesses in a clear and compelling way, but that's something a lot of entrepreneurs struggle with, and it's something you need to know how to do so you can convert your audience into more sales. And that's why I've created this course. It's a 6-week audio course to teach you how to craft a signature talk so that you can authentically give value and close more of your audience from the stage. In the class, you learn how to create a clear and compelling point of view, how to organize your content and give great value to your audience without giving away the farm, how to structure your talk so that it seamlessly closes your audience at the end without feeling salesy, and I also give you templates and instructions how to create marketing materials, a speaker sheet, and all kinds of sign-up sheets when you're giving your talks. And finally, what everybody's hot to know, I also give you tips and resources on how to find speaking gigs. It's an all-inclusive course so that you can start closing and selling more from the stage. And as my free gift to you for tuning into the podcast, I'm giving you my free webinar, also called Close Any Room, and you can listen to it at clearvoicebranding.com/close-any-room. And it will give you lots of tips and information to get you started on how to create that signature talk that sells. Okay, we're going to get back to the show now. There's still more great content to come. Thanks for joining me.
Yeah, I love what you said. Play with who's fun. Because I think that's a mistake a lot of people make is they're with somebody, and it's nothing against the other person. This other person may be a lovely person, but they're with somebody and they're thinking, I should be around this person. I should be trying, you know, spending time with this person. And they're not really having that joy interacting with them. And I think we've all been there. And the thing that's so cool is when you find your people who, you know, in whatever circle of life that you are roaming, it lights you up so much.
Right. And you walk away and you're like,
go back.
Oh my
that.
Gosh, how come I haven't been doing this all along? Right. And you know, there's studies on happiness and they find that it's not, you know, we think it's about the money and the big house and the shoulds and it's really about your relationships and who you're connected with, that when people are at the later stages of their life and they look back, they go, oh God, that's what made me happy. That's what it was about. So I think we have to constantly self-check, constantly say, what is working? What is not working? Where do I need help? Where am I okay? And then just go for it. Ask for help. Ask for help from a trusted friend. Ask for help from someone you work with that you feel connected to. Because I think that, especially, you know, speaking as a mom, I want my kids to know what to do when they're feeling stuck. I want them to, you know, I don't want to grab a cup of coffee in the morning and say, go eat your breakfast. You know, that doesn't make any sense to me. I want them to live fully. I want them to question life. And I took on that responsibility when I became a mom. And so I have to model that. And my clients, they get that. They feel the same way.
That's awesome. That's awesome. And I love what you said about connections. And I love what I do because I get to connect with cool people like you. So at the end of my life, I'm going to be, I think I got it right.
Very hard to get it right. Right?
Well, thank you. But I mean, one of the great gifts is interacting and connecting with people.
I love it too. In fact, you know, when I was, somebody asked me, they're like, did you always know this is what you wanted to do? And I thought back to when I was a little girl and I was the kid who played school. I was the kid who played being a mommy, and helping and doing those things. So it's really powerful when you are doing something in your life that truly aligns with what you feel in your gut and your heart.
So I think when I was in kindergarten, I was organizing singing groups. So so I think it's, you know, full circle,
absolutely,
helping people sing and find their voice. So that's awesome. So we're sort of kind of coming to the end of the time, but I wanted to ask you before, just one question is, what are two or three tips that people can do right now that are simple to be happier and healthier? I know you said the water before. Mm-hmm. Do you have a couple of more?
I think that take 10 minutes today. Take 10 minutes and write down what really brings you joy and happiness. And look at that list. A few times this week and see where you're in alignment with it. Really figure that out. So from just a overall broad perspective, I think that's an important exercise. I do it. I check in, you know, all the time. In terms of just having better energy so that you can have clarity in your life, find a way to move every day. Put on some loud music. Jump around your living room. You can video record it if you want or do it
it's your show, baby. Do what you want.
Do something to move your body. It will feel really good. And find the foods that fuel you rather than the foods that drain you. And that, I know it's a process. It's a really broad suggestion. Number one, definitely do the water. But even if it's just adding more vegetables, even if you're listening to this and you're like, oh, you know, I had a salad, you know, last week. Be mindful of that, because if you're fueling your body the best you can, you're really going to have the clarity of mind to create the life that you want.
Yeah, I think that's super important, because clarity of mind to have the life that you want, I think to make more money in your business, to be more impactful to the people that you want to help. I think that's huge, because if you're fuzzy, if you're not energetic, you're not going to have those mental resources or those emotional or energetic
and
resources
quite often
to do
business,
what you want to do.
You know, as entrepreneurs and working a business, we are the worst at taking care of ourselves. Because we are going. Mm-hmm. But you're going to go. And you're going to fall.
That's why I think those morning, if you can set bookends in your day, it doesn't have to be morning and evening. Maybe it's morning and afternoon, but morning I think is really important that you schedule that time, that is your ritual time, or that's for your clients. Maybe the time is in their calendar. They're going to chop their veggies. Right, that is
a priority. But even tomorrow morning, you know, wake
up,
you know, you heard this chat and wake up in the morning and Take three deep breaths. Rest your body. Ah. Look in the mirror and say, it's going to be an awesome day. You know, just find what works for you, but pick one or two things starting tomorrow that you're going to commit to, even if it's for the next week. Just do it. See how it feels.
Yeah, I love that. I love it. And I love, you know what, I love the best thing, the whole other things that you're talking about, mm-hmm. Jen, is that it's customized. What works for you is not going to work for the next person. But so, and vice versa.
You have
so
to
try it out.
It's like clothes. You have to
try. Right. I heard it. Yeah. And I heard an interview with Sarah, what's her last name? She's the owner of Spanx, right? Oh, the billionaire Spanx owner. And she was telling this story that her dad, every day after school or maybe every week, I don't remember which one it was, said, what did you fail at today? What did you fail at this week? Because he wanted them to be trying instead of just like always succeeding. He's like, you know, be adventurous in your life, try things, fail at things, and then you'll know.
Right. And if you don't try it, you don't know. That's kind of happening with people is they're not even trying something new. And I think you're absolutely right, Heather, is that you might get up in the morning and deep breathing, you know, every morning for the next week and be like, you know, this is not really resonating with me. That's okay. There are so many things you can be doing. Get up and do some yoga. Go for a run. Go for a run at whatever it might be.
Or call Jen and see if she can help you out. So how can people, if people want to get in touch with you or find out more about your services or what you do, how can they reach you?
Contact me through my website at jenklofsky.com. I love phone calls. Yep. I actually really love connecting with people via Skype or over the phone because I think we get a much better feel for each other that way. So give me a call, 617-947-9300.
Okay, cool. And I put your URL in the chat so cool. People can see that too. Yeah, so cool. This blab is cool. Cool. So now just two last questions because I always like to ask this. When you think of people who are really rocking it out, who are really stars at what they do, and they've figured it out, what common things do you think that they have?
Yes.
Someone who's really a star, who's
got support.
It. What are they doing that's right?
They have support.
Good
not
answer.
Doing it on their own. I think that the most successful people that I know in life and in business are always surrounding themselves with people who are more successful than them when it comes to business or doing things that they want to model after in their lives. But finding some way to get that support, whether it's in a community or with a coach or with even if it's an online community, I don't think that you should do things on your own. I think that's a big misconception and we begin to feel very isolated. So
that's a great answer. And I'm actually reading a book right now about nonverbal communication. And it's talking about cavemen and how they communicated with each other, you know, when they were just grunting along in the cave. And the book said the two things that all human beings want is leadership and connection. So it's exactly what you just said. Get a community or find someone that's a role model, that's mentoring, that's teaching,
finding
whatever it is. I totally
is really
agree
important.
With that.
And finding your authentic tribe. I mean, there's so many ways you can get involved with other people, but find, going back to what fuels you rather than what drains you, that might take a little bit of time figuring that out.
Yeah. And surround yourself with awesome people like Loretta. Loretta is such a hot ticket. Thank you so much for joining us, Loretta. It's great.
And the one other thing I did want to share with you is that I'm actually, not only do I have private practice, but I'm collaborating with a woman who you actually know, Carrie Yassi. And we are, we have a program for women and we are creating a community specifically for women who are really at this place in their lives where they are seeking more from their lives. It's called Life of More. And if people would like to learn more about that, certainly give me a call or contact me again through my website.
I love it. That's great. To have that community. So last question I always ask everybody. I know that you have so much to be grateful for. And in this moment, as just right now, in this present moment, what do you think that you're most grateful for?
That's an amazing question. I am extremely grateful for my family, and I'm extremely grateful that I can share my love of helping people with all of you. I'm extremely fortunate to be able to do what I love every single day.
That's awesome. And I'm very grateful for you. I want to thank you for being here. And I'm grateful for the light that you bring into the world, your energy. And I love that you give people the space to make their own choices and to honor them. And that's a very unique gift that you bring. Not all coaches do that. They have their formulas, and sometimes it's this formula or bye-bye, but you really help people find what works for them. And that is a very unique, special gift. And your warmth and your humor and your energy and your love and your smarts. I'm so grateful for your presence in the world and in our
lives. Thank you. And thank you for all you're doing.
Thank you for joining.
Helping me get clear on my messaging and providing this forum for people to just gain knowledge and figure out what they want is such a gift. So I appreciate everything that you're doing. It's just really wonderful.
Thank you. It's my pleasure. And thank you all for joining us as well. And Loretta, I'm so happy to see you there. Thank you, everybody. And as always, my special gift for joining me is my free webinar, Close Any Room, where you can learn to speak to add thousands to your monthly income. And you can visit clearvoicebranding.com/close-any-room and listen freely there. Thank you so much for being here. Bye-bye. Take care. Until next time. Here's to hitting your high notes. Bye-bye.
Hi, everyone. Thank you so much for joining me for this episode of Thrive. I loved having you here. I love having you as part of my community. And if you're enjoying the show, I would love it if you share it with your friends on Twitter, on Facebook, or wherever they're hanging out. I also want to let you know you can leave me feedback or comments. I love hearing from you. Just post those at heatherpoduska.com. You can also leave suggestions for topics that you'd like to know more about, or if there's someone you'd really like to see on the show, let me know that as well. Okay, until next time, here's to hitting all your high notes. Take care. Bye-bye.